What's happening YouTube? Welcome back to another video. It's not so much a happy video. We've just nearly lost all the monster fish. Bad schoolboy error. So let's get into it. So guys, I'll spin you around. So the electrician's been, he's upgraded the electrics as I said, and he's wired the lights in for the fish room. And I was playing around with bulbs, as you can tell they're different colours, and I've got to get some more white ones now. So while I'm doing that, I've also finished my water change off. I've aired out the EasyPod system. Obviously the air pump, which isn't connected now, releases all the crap out the Micro K1. So I've done all that, got the hose pipe in, put my dechlorinator in, and when I do the first part of the water change, I fire in the water pretty quick on the faucet on the end of the hose pipe. So it's basically just a flushing system, so it's mixing and it's getting rid of the crap and putting decent water in. So I've done all that, so then I'll keep the hose pipe on. So while I'm keeping the hose pipe on, I'm playing with the light bulbs. Bearing in mind that I forgot that normally I let the temperature get to 20 degrees pretty quick, and then I top it back up slowly over the course of 2 to 3 hours, however long it takes to get back up to temperature. I don't like it going any less than 20. It went down to, well, I realised it went down to 12.5 degrees. And I literally, you know what I'm going to say, but I can't say it, but yeah. Jumped in the cupboard. Luckily, like I say, the electric system's been upgraded. Grabbed the Inkbird alarm system. This is for the pond when it's done. Got the two big 650 watt DD titanium meters in. But this is telling me it's 16.5 degrees. So I'm thinking, oh, I've let it go a bit more than normal. It'll be fine. No, then it's not. Then I start noticing the fish going absolutely mental. This bloody thing here doesn't tell you the right temperature. 23.1. No, it's not. It's 20.5. I've got it set for 26.5, which I always have that one at. They lie. Inkbird, best alarm system. I haven't really used it, but I have watched a lot of people who have this, and this is why I've got it, to go on the big air source heat pump system for the pond. So yeah, so Pearl, the albino giant gourami. Oh, that's another one, sorry guys. This bloody FX6 drains itself. I forgot to turn the taps off, this is another nightmare I've had. Drained itself, I'm filling it back up, it decides to kick in. While these aren't on, I literally have just been showered by a load of fish water by that. And literally was fighting it, put it back on, going, no, no, no. And it was all in my face, and yeah, it's been one of them afternoons. So Pearl the albino giant gourami was on a side on the bottom, not moving. The two big arowanas, the albino and the silver, not moving. The two Oscars, they were, yeah, you can probably guess. The catfish weren't too bad, apart from ravishing the big red-tailed cat. He was nearly dead. The big clown knife was nearly dead. She's made a real, I don't even know how she's still here. I really don't. So luckily, I've had a new boiler in the house, and I've got proper hot water. And I've got a load of water jugs, which are them ones you have from a drinks dispenser in an office or wherever, you know, the big blue ones. You take the cap off and you put them upside down on the drinks. I've got a load of them. I've literally just been putting water straight out the tap into them, running it into here, and it's fetched the temperature up from 12.5 to 18.5 degrees with, like, I don't know, 300 litres of water. But by God, it was a panic. I was literally, that albino silver arowana, I don't even know how it's still swimming, honestly guys. And I've always said in my other videos, I don't normally pump fresh water straight in. I do for the first part, like I say, with a faucet on and that, but I've got distracted by them bloody LED lights. I turned around and the fish, I'm like, oh no. So yeah guys, it's not always good, and I will show you the bad times of fish keeping, because it's not good at all. It's not always good. You do have problems and, you know, shit happens, but yeah. So the plan was today to just do a water change on that, do the piranha tank, do the turtle tank. No, I'm sat here now just watching these and just hoping to God they're all right, and they do seem all right. They're doing the normal thing. The only ones it didn't affect was Big Kyle and the Panda Red Tail and the Pleco, me and Pablo, the big sailfin plet. But yeah, I was, if they'd have died through my own errors today, I'd have got rid of everything. I would have been done today, I'll tell you now. I'm not spending that much money again. And you know, like I say, it happens, but you know, I couldn't have brought myself to do all this again. I've had these fish now, I had all of them that long, I'd say possibly a couple of years, a couple of them, but yeah. No, I built this collection over a 2-year period, and I just nearly lost them all just from a stupid mistake of firing cold water in out of the tap. So yeah. Sorry guys. Yeah, that's another one. The only one it actually didn't affect was Gary the Gar. He's a bloody dinosaur though, and he survived the ice age, so he's probably not doing too bad. Yeah, the snakehead weren't too good either, the emperor snakehead. Sorry if I have mentioned it before guys, I'm literally just jabbering on, but yeah, it was scary, very scary. Seeing Pearl flap around like a fish out of water, in water, and the arowanas were just like, just literally like bent over, and it was horrible. I am going to upload this video as well, just to give you a bit of info. Yeah, don't ever leave your water changes unattended. And the good thing is, when I built the pond, I'm having a hot water system plumbed in, so I can do like decent temperatures. I'm going to get a plumber come and do the temperature so that I can do water changes in this pond build, so that they don't, you know, change any parameters as much, or temperature as much. So yeah, it was scary, really scary. So thanks for watching guys, please consider subscribing, like the videos and share them if you want, and I will see you on the next one when we'll have block work going into the pond build. Peace out guys.